Someone spilled wine on me last night.
Oh, wow.
He's gonna maybe try this Clorox real quick. Look at that. Whoa, see, that just stained the whole jacket. I have like a interview in like a few minutes, but we'll be cool. In the van, so it'll be cool. Yeah.
Life is sleeping, all it days, and yeah, I know I'm sleeping, cause this dream's too amazing. She got gold on eyes where her eyes used to be, yeah. One turn and I learned what it really means to see, yeah.
I think the larger the venues get, the more the juxtaposition of our messiness, if you will, or our allowance to sort of improvise, the contrast will become, I think, much greater as the venues get bigger.
You never do anything by yourself, you know.
I'm a Robot made what I considered to be a really shitty album. And it was sort of heartbreaking. The experience of making it was sort of heartbreaking. I was coming out of a phase of hyper-intellectual, robotic thought. And any of the magic of my childhood had been sort of leached from my actions and my thoughts. I tried to think back to when I was a kid and like what I liked listening to when I was a kid, what I thought of myself when I was a kid, what I thought of the world when I was a kid. And from that, looking back, I eventually started making this kind of music just because that's more what I was exposed to.
Can we try just analyzing that section real quick? Because it would be cool if it survived on its own, like if I didn't have to come in right away with the... Yeah.
I first saw Jade at a party, and she came sort of galloping up, and I was so taken by her, just her energy, and she was just laughing hysterically as she sort of skipped up.
Yes, it's only loving, only trying, only love, spend God's heart, trying, only love, only want to love you, but it's getting.
But I didn't really get to know her until years later. As she was sitting on this curb, and I bicycled up, and we got to talking, and I was just making music all the time, and by proximity, we just ended up sort of writing songs. Sort of from there on, we were just sort of inseparable. Yeah, just best friends from then on, really.
So how long until showtime?
I believe it's 7 o'clock right now. Edward Sharpe goes on at 8:15. They don't really do some of this. I think they have like an intro that they're gonna do into the first song or into the second song, and from there it's anyone's guess.
My ritual is playing this one scale on every guitar that I have. But while we're hanging out, I don't know, not really like a set thing while we're just...
You guys got a squeegee.
Yeah. But they got you the goo, they're gonna do the goo. Dead again, dead again. Dead again, you the goo.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, she knows what's going on.
Dead again, you the goo.
This is the first time we've really just been able to hang out before a show too, though, you know? So, I'm sure some rituals will develop over time.
freaking find my passport.
That's a shocker.
Something about it.
All right, let's jam.
All right.
Love you guys.
Yeah.